I like installing AVRs on things that probably shouldn't have AVRs, and making AVRs do things they probably shouldn't do. They're tiny little microcontrollers, really small. This one's about the size of a pencil eraser. One of the things I've done historically was get these little guys to go make NTSC video. That means outputting video to these old analog sets, or even newer sets. So, it's working just fine. This one actually doesn't need any external components. All it has is the two little bypass caps. It has a little ADC running so I can see the voltage of this little slider here, and a little graph, almost like an oscilloscope, just very slow, of what the voltages were. And it's overclocked about 30 megahertz, and it's just generating this NTSC video. You might be wondering, so what's different about this video than the previous one? It's not plugged into the television. So what we're actually doing here is this little ATTiny85 has using the internal PLL with the 60 megahertz clock as the primary frequency. And it's taking that and it's using the timer 1 output with the timer 1 output and the inverting output and the dead time generator in order to create a roughly 60 megahertz signal that's going to be on channel 3. It's all I can really tune my TV to because I lost the remote. So in order to encode or AM modulate the different things, we can either use one pin, the other pin, both pins, or neither pin. So what I'm actually doing here is the two antennas are slightly different lengths, and that's because the amount of brightness that would come from them would be different. So the difference between sync tip, which is when in an inverted space for AM, you have to have the full signal, both pins on, and black level, which is where one of the pins would be on. You need to be able to have even less proportionally in order to display full white. That's because black level is at 40 and white is at 100. So with this, we can now encode the AVR, encode the NTSC on the AVR and modulate it to VHF, to the TV, without a whole lot of hubbub. You know, I don't really see any technical reason why you wouldn't be able to, say, take this project and the half duplex AVR project, which was using the exact same processor, and say make a closed caption Twitter bot. I can't, because I don't have the remote control of that TV to turn on closed captioning, but you can.
If you'd like to learn more about NTSC, I have a Let's Learn, Let's Code on it, so you can click on this video right here. Don't forget to subscribe!
When you look at your television, what you're actually seeing is a number of scan lines. The idea behind this is televisions up until recently were cathode ray tubes. They could only actually